Welcome back, everybody. Hope everyone's doing well. This week's question is, what entity should you choose for your deal? Well, to cut to the chase, if you're doing a real estate syndication, 9 times out of 10, you're going to choose an LLC. That's what almost everyone uses in this industry, and that's probably what you're going to use too. But why LLC? What's so great about an LLC? Well, if you want to find out, keep watching. But first, for everybody new to the channel, my name is Jon Nieh. I am one of the founding partners here at Trowbridge Law Group. And although I am an attorney, I am not your attorney. So this is not legal advice. None of the videos we produce for this channel is legal advice. So don't take it as legal advice. If you want legal advice, give us a call, hire us as your attorneys, and we'll gladly give you legal advice. Anyways, if you also enjoy this content, please like, comment, and subscribe. So, why LLCs? Why does everyone in this industry use LLCs? Well, 3 main reasons that I think that make LLCs so great. Number one, first reason, limited liability. It's literally in the name of LLCs. LLCs are limited liability companies. What does that mean? What is limited liability? Well, generally speaking, companies don't protect the owners of the companies from liability, right? So if you own a business as a sole proprietor, right, you didn't use the entity at all, anyone that sued the business could sue you as an individual, can go after your individual assets. So if someone sued you as a sole proprietor, so sued your business for some reason, or a creditor, or someone is coming after your business for debt or whatever, and they found that the company is liable for that debt or for that, you know, whatever happened in that lawsuit, that person can now sue you, can go after you and your personal assets. So anything that wasn't even used in the business, they can go after and potentially seize, right? So your house, your personal house that you didn't even use in the business. Well, if you use an entity like an LLC, then you have limited liability if you're the owner of the LLC. So if something were to happen with the business and the business gets sued, the LLC gets sued, these people can't sue you personally for your personal assets. They can't go after your house, right? So if you're doing a real estate syndication, if you're doing a real estate deal, that's probably going to be very, very important to you, because at any property, something can go wrong. An accident can happen. Tenants can, get hurt at the property, and they might sue the LLC. They might sue the business that owns the property. Well, if that were to happen, these people won't be able to go after you individually for your personal assets, right? You want to be able to protect those things from potential lawsuits from the business. So that's why LLCs are so great, right? Because it shields the members of the LLC from liability, from personal assets. If you were to use, say, a partnership, right, a general partnership, generally speaking, the partners in a general partnership are liable personally for anything that happens with the partnership. So if you did a syndication with the general partnership and a tenant gets hurt on the property and they sue the general partnership, the tenant could potentially sue each partner individually as well and go after their personal assets. That's why an LLC is so much better than using a partnership. So that's reason number one. Reason number two is probably, I think, the main reason why people in our business and syndications generally use LLCs is the fact that it allows for pass-through taxation. And what I've seen really in every industry, taxes kind of affect everything, right? The taxes kind of dictate a lot of business decisions. And for this one, what entity to choose, taxation has a huge influence on your choice. So LLCs have pass-through taxation. What that means is LLCs are only taxed one time at the individual member level, or at the partner level, because you're electing to be taxed as a partnership as opposed to a corporation. So corporations have double taxation, generally speaking. If you're a C Corp, you are taxed twice, right? You're taxed at the corporate level, the entity level, and then again at the shareholder level, the underlying owner level. So if you use a corporation, you are potentially paying not necessarily double the taxes, but you're potentially paying more taxes because you're taxed twice, right? The company is taxed, and then you, the individual owner, is taxed as well. LLC, if you elect to be taxed as a partnership, you can, you know, use pass-through taxation, and you're only taxed one time. So the LLC is not taxed, right? It's pass-through. The individual owners of the LLC are the only ones that have to pay taxes. So less taxes. And, you know, less taxes mean more people want to use LLCs because they don't want to pay taxes. So that's probably the main reason why LLCs are so prevalent in our industry, is the fact that it allows for you to choose to be taxed as a partnership and only pay taxes at the partner level, the underlying owner level. The third reason, it's a little bit, you know, more ancillary, not really a big reason that LLCs are so great and why they're so prevalent in our industry. But the reason why I think contributes to it a little bit is the fact that they're easy to get rid of, right? So to get rid of an LLC, you have to file dissolution papers, you know, dissolving the LLC. So it's basically one document you file with the state, and the LLC is dissolved. Obviously, there's some, you know, work that you do in the background as far as distributing all the assets to the LLC, selling everything off, and you know, closing the books for all the owners of the LLC. But as far as the state is concerned, all you gotta do is file articles of dissolution, is what is most often called. File that, and the LLC is dissolved. Compare that to a corporation, it's much, much, much more difficult to get rid of a corporation. There's so many different little processes that you have to take care of, that you have to legally go through to get rid of a corporation. Because, as a lot of people know, corporations are essentially people. And because it's a person, a corporation has a lot of rights. So it's a very, very complicated process to get rid of a corporation. It's not easy. But the benefit of a corporation is they're a lot easier to grow and to keep surviving even after the original owners aren't necessarily alive still. And that's why you see a lot of Fortune 500 companies, corporations, organized corporations, you know, tech companies, corporations, anyone that wants to raise money from stock markets, from public markets in the future, uses a corporation, because they're very easy to issue new shares for, to raise capital for, to continue to grow and exist in perpetuity. You know, that's why corporations are, you find them in that space more often than not. But, you know, they're very difficult to get rid of as compared to an LLC. And if you're doing a real estate syndication, you are using the LLC for a very specific purpose of this property that you're going to acquire and eventually sell. And when you sell it, you want to get rid of the entity that was holding it. So that's why an LLC is very, very useful in this case, because you could just, you know, sell the property, get rid of it, and then dissolve the LLC, and then bam, the deal is done. You've distributed returns to your investors, everybody's happy, no more creditors, and it's done, and now you can move on to your next deal. So that's why it kind of, you know, adds to the prevalence of LLCs. Anyways, that's the three main reasons that LLCs are, you know, pretty much almost exclusively used in our industry. So number one, limited liability. Number two, pass-through taxation or single taxation. And number three, they're very, very easy to get rid of. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope it was very educational. You know, if you did enjoy it, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next week. Thanks for tuning in.